Alright, this is a brief explanation and a play along with arpeggio exercise number one. Okay, what I recommend is going measure by measure and checking out the different right hand patterns. For example, in measure one, we have M, I, A, I. So only with your right hand, right, no left hand, just practice the right hand exercise. M, I, A, I. M, I, A, I. The second measure, so it's M, I, P, I. M, I, P, I. M, I, P, I. Now, I recommend doing this, practice each right hand pattern, because there's pretty much different right hand patterns for each measure. So without doing the left hand, just only focus on the right hand. Alright? Now another thing you have to realize is arpeggio exercises. So whatever finger you put down, you keep it on. So for example, in the first measure we have we first start with a C, right? When we play a C, we hold it down because it outlines what we call a C major chord. So in that measure, we do not let it go. In the second measure, we start with a B, and then we put down D, 3. Okay? And I would follow all the fingering that's written in. For example, measure 3 has 1 on F, and then has for D, instead of third finger, it has the fourth finger, your pinky. Now I would keep that because in the future when you play chords and stuff, you might have to do this kind of fingering. Very common. So I would keep that fingering. Then we go to the D, fourth finger. Okay? Alright, let's do a little play along here. You count off 3 and 4 and